Hi, I'm Kendra, and I want to share with you a few tips on the Visual Studio test tools. So let's dive right in. Here I'm in Visual Studio 2022, and the first tip I want to show is Show in Test Explorer. This is a brand new feature. So this is available if I just right-click in any test method, and it pops open the Test Explorer to kind of show exactly the test that I was just editing in the editor. So it kind of keeps your context very in sync. So even if I had all of these collapsed, I could also do the same thing. So show in Test Explorer, I could use Control ES, that's a keyboard shortcut, and it'll expand all of the parent nodes and everything. So makes it really easy to find tests. This is a lot like sync an active document. If you've used this in the Solution Explorer, it'll highlight the file that you have open in the code editor as well. So kind of trying to use some kind of consistent tooling across these is a very highly requested feature, and we're awfully excited about it. Oh, one thing I should also call out is we have the expand all button now. So very helpful. We had a collapse all. We were limiting it for a little bit because we were worried for people with hundreds of thousands of test spaces, it would have some performance concerns. But now we got it in and super easy to expand all of your tests. So the next thing I want to show off is test audio cues. So I'll go ahead and run this test. And you might have heard a subtle little chime in the background. Let me do that again. Let's run a failing test this time. So this is a test audio cue that plays at the end of test runs. So we have two sounds, one for if the test run contained all passing tests, and another for if there is at least one failing test. So it started as an accessibility feature, but obviously it's in and now we can all benefit from it whenever we are multitasking or we got distracted. It'll kind of bring you back. You kicked off a test run and now it's completed and ready for you. And yes, you can absolutely configure the sounds on these. Just go to Tools Options and click Configure Sounds. It'll open the Windows 10 dialog. And we have a few sound points already that you can configure for Visual Studio, and these are the two new ones. And you can have a lot of fun with this. So any WAV file that you want to use, we can actually support. So something you could really have a lot of fun with this. You know, if you want to, just a suggestion. So that was test audio cues. Another thing I want to call out is the Test Explorer also now captures Console.Writeline in the Test Detail Summary pane. So that's this pane over here. We didn't always capture Console.Writeline, but a lot of people would use it for logs when they were translating code. So all of standard output and standard error are captured now. And we have some really helpful wrapping functions. So if it's ever scrolling off the pane or you want to use fixed width font or something like that to compare two lines, you can unwrap and you can wrap it again just to make sure that you see all of the useful dialogue or messages that you want to see. We also kind of changed how we truncate output. So we now show a much, much larger preview in the pane as well before we decide, hey, we need to truncate this, just open this additional log and you can still get all of your logs. So that is log output appearing in the Test Explorer, very useful. Now, one of the major things that I want to talk about, this is remote testing, which is very new in Visual Studio 2022. This is the idea of connecting your Visual Studio Test Explorer to a remote environment. So it could be a Linux container, WSL, or even over SSH, like an entirely separate VM. And this is useful because normally I would have to push to CI to get feedback from my Linux tests. But now I can get it all inside of my inner dev loop. So let me show you a little bit of how that works. This feature is sort of bring your own compute. So you need to have your own Docker file. So I'll go ahead and build my Docker image with my developer PowerShell. So I'll run a quick Docker build there. And I'll take a look at my tests. So I have two tests here. One is running on Linux and one is running on Windows. And I'm using the XUnit skippable fact attribute. So if my Linux test is on Windows, I'll skip it. depending on what operating system it is, and vice versa for Windows. If my Windows test is trying to execute on Linux, it'll go ahead and skip that as well. So now that I have my Docker image built, I can kind of take a look at what environments I have available in my Test Explorer dropdown. And I'll go ahead and select the container that I want to connect to. Now, this is determined by my testenvironment.json file up here that kind of declares all of the connections that my Test Explorer can connect to. So I have container, and it asks for like what Docker image I have running on my machine, or what WSL distribution, for example, and my SSH credentials. And that's how I get all of that kind of set up. So when I selected to run in the Linux container here, it's going ahead and starting up that container for me, and it's going to rediscover my tests. There we go. So it started up a container, and it's now rediscovered my tests. So I'm going to go ahead and rerun these. And now my Windows test should be skipped, and my Linux test is now passing. So it's bringing sort of that modern cross-platform development into your inner loop, and you can debug these on Linux and get that feedback from your Linux environments right here in Visual Studio. So speaking of sort of more modern development, I also want to talk a little bit about Playwright. That is the new web UI testing framework that Microsoft has released. It's entirely open source. It is built with asynchronous and cross-platform code in mind. It works with all modern browsers, and it works for multiple languages, including TypeScript, Python, .NET, and Java. And with any web UI testing technology, the first question, where is the recorder? Do we have a recorder? Yes, yes, we absolutely have a recorder for Playwright. So let me show you a little bit of what that looks like. I'll go ahead and launch the Playwright Recorder. So this is, you know, a cross-platform tool. So I'm going to use this CLI to do it from the developer PowerShell. And it'll go ahead and launch an Edge browser for me. And it'll be blank right now because I didn't input any web address to go to. And here on the side, it starts up this Playwright Inspector. So now when I navigate anywhere, let's take a gander at the Playwright docs. It kind of starts logging things as I do them. And you can see as I'm hovering in my browser, it's telling me, you know, what elements are going to be called and logging them as I click. So let's take a look at supported languages. I can click on .NET and it generates all of this for me. And I can easily copy out of here and put it in other tests wherever I need to in my code. So let's take a look at one of those. So you can see it said, hey, you're going to start. You can start either headlessly or not. So I'm keeping this headless right now so I can debug through this with Visual Studio. It also gave me helpful asserts so I can actually check, you know, what the expected values are at certain parts when I was recording it. Just super helpful. So if I go ahead and run this, since I am running with a head, not headlessly, I'm going to see the browser actually pop up and I could set breakpoints and step through it if I wanted to. But now it's just going to replay those actions that I just recorded and the test passed. Let's see. There we go. The test passed. So that's a little bit of Playwright development that helps bring your modern apps all into your inner dev loop. Thanks so much for taking a look at the Visual Studio test tools. Take a look at our other videos on Visual Studio 2022. They're pretty cool. Thanks for watching.